So, I mean, when someone is, say, getting high or, not solving the problem that they need to solve, so the pain must still be there, right? Or should they, like,
Yeah, the pain is there, but they call the painkiller called moral superiority. They want that pain. They're like, see how much pain you're making for me. They like it. You can enjoy pain as long as you're getting something out of it. You're proving a point about how morally superior you are. People take it. That's called martyrdom, okay? Didn't Bhagat Singh know that he's going to be hanged if he does whatever he does? Of course he knew. It wasn't a surprise for him. He went shouting, Inqilab Zindabad, even to the gallows when they hung him. That's called a martyr, right? Well, martyrs undergo pain willingly. They don't feel any pain. They have the moral superiority of being right. Right? Bhagat Singh was obviously right. Whole nation agrees that he was right. The problem with martyrs at home in domestic situation is whole nation doesn't agree that they're right. But still, they get some superiority from it. I say, just look at my suffering. Look at me suffering in silence. You know the suffering? It's because of you. Recently, a patient of mine died because of this. Not even COVID, okay? She just hadn't eaten for many years and then she died. By the time they came to me for a solution, she did the grand passing away because she knew, after talking to me, she knew that she had to find a solution if she continued with my treatment. So she passed away. She thought it's better to die than solve this problem. So they are feeling pain. They're enjoying that death. Yeah. It's such a happy event for her. That's a really sad part. That people do feel pain and they never get out of their pain and they enjoy their pain. Boggles the mind. And after she died, I met her. Because all the souls that die end up in the Mahakali River. Because there's a river called Mahakali that separates the living from the dead. You have to cross it twice. When you die, you cross it and you end up in the world of the non-living. And then you have to cross it again if you want to take another birth. And most people get stuck there for many years. Not years, but you can't count years there. It's just for long lengths of time. People get stuck. So I went there and I asked her, like, have you had enough of this crap? Like, do you enjoy this? Did you like this story? She's like, yeah, it was good. It's like, do you want a better story, something more glorious? She's like, yeah, I do. He said, will you teach me yoga? I said, yeah, cool. Go die and go take birth and come back. I'll teach you. Don't do this shit anymore. Aren't you tired now? You'll have to be born again. You'll have to learn to toilet train yourself again. You have to learn language again. You have to hit puberty again. Be confused about boys again. Do you want to do this shit all over again? And then society will put pressure on you to get married. And if you're a man, it's no better, right? You can choose whether you want to be a woman or a man. It's not really any better for a man. The pressures about getting married and stuff, and always supposed to know what to do. Whether you're a leader or not, leadership is thrust on you if you're a man. And whether you want to lead or not, leadership is thrust on you. There's lots of things to learn. Language, just learning to express yourself and communicate something, learning about human emotions, learning about human lies. That itself will take one lifetime if you don't have a guru. You can't learn these things. So I had a long conversation with that soul. And she said, yeah. I don't want to do this kind of stuff again. And then she vanished. Okay. But this is yoga. Our story is only different. It's glorious. It's a story that connects from across births. And that's why it makes sense. But people don't want to learn that. Oh, how can that be? I didn't learn about it in school, so I don't want to learn it. So I'm like, okay, go die then. Yeah. Smithy saying, not puberty again. Yeah, I know, right? What a mess. Suddenly bleeding all over the place. You don't have an idea what the hell happened. My God. Why you need this again? So don't ruin your lives. Just to feel morally superior. It's not worth it. However, people don't believe me when I say this. They're like,
he's making these things up. How can he go to a river and take dead people across?
Like, you know everything. You know?